Gemini Discover. We are in the middle of a lockdown in Seattle, but there is essential media services allowed. So we're cruising through downtown trying to photograph and videotape the effects of the lockdown on the city.
Yeah, just to be clear, I do have an editorial assignment to take photos for a client. So I'm out here as credentialed media, and Martin's here as my driver slash assistant. And so yeah, we're not out here for fun. We are out here to do a job, and we're not encouraging people just to go out and violate the stay in place order. But yeah, we're hoping just to get some capture footage to show what's happening here in Seattle. This is our first full day of the official lockdown, where only essential businesses are supposed to be open and operating. And right now it's about 12:30 p.m. Should be really busy for lunch. And so yeah, we're just gonna see what everything looks like.
So far what we're seeing is quite a lot of traffic, but it's lighter than it would be normally. It's more like downtown would be on a weekend in the winter or something like that. The streets are rather empty, but not completely empty. There's still plenty of cars going around.
Yeah, the thing about Seattle is that we already like to not quite shelter in place, but people socially distance just automatically. There's this thing called the Seattle Freeze. If you haven't heard of it, look it up. And I think they're saying that that possibly is why the virus isn't spreading so badly in Seattle, because we already kind of keep our distance, especially in the winter time. So yeah, this seriously feels like Seattle on a weekend. It doesn't look really that different or drastic to me.
Yeah, Seattle does have the Northern European culture, which is pretty antisocial, and it actually is helping us right now. We do normally have massive events, but they're not happening right now, so the big gatherings are pretty much canceled, and the way people normally live is rather in small groups. So this is not a very big change for us, other than actually not being able to go out too much by law. But here we're gonna turn into Pike Place Market, normally pretty popular tourist destination in our city, and see how many people.
Slow down, just move. Sorry, I wasn't ready to film that. All right.
The market is mostly emptied out.
I think that's another journalist in there. People out with cameras. Everyone's trying to, I think I'm gonna get out here too and do some shots.
Okay, I gotta pull over.
Yeah.
Just keep your distance.
Yeah, just go up. Some places are just, go to the road.
So I'm chauffeuring, and Susie is gonna be going in and out very quickly and not near people to take some of the shots. at the Amazon campus, which is normally the busiest part of downtown during lunchtime, but right now it's abandoned, and it has been abandoned for a month. It's completely empty. And Amazon campus is urban and is made up of over 50 buildings in downtown Seattle, so it's quite a lot of people missing right now. Construction still continues everywhere so far in Seattle, but today is the first day that they've issued the order, so we could see a difference. I actually don't see workers in this construction site.
Wow, that's a big site.
Yeah. And yesterday there were workers where we saw them.
So like Pioneer Square, downtown Pike Place Market area, then up to like the Amazon corporate office area. And what did you think?
Well, I think that it's very naive for the governments to think that people will simply obey, because they're not, and there's no enforcement at all anywhere. And so we saw many people just breaking the law and going to parks and doing all kinds of things. It's less than it would be on a normal day, but it's still quite a bit.
Yeah, like we were kind of paranoid. We've actually been self-containing and social distancing since like early March before we even really had to. And so for us, we really haven't been out to see kind of what's been going on. So so before we went out, I actually printed out my credentials and I was like, here's a little area in, you know, the newspaper that says that I'm an essential business, I'm allowed to be out here. We really were kind of worried that we might get questioned. But once we started, you know, just seeing that there are quite a few people out, and yeah, there are police. I see there, I think that there's actually heavier police presence downtown just because there's not a whole lot of cars to really compete with them, so maybe they just stick out more. So they are there. I even saw the meter maid writing tickets for parking, so they're still out there doing stuff. But yeah, I didn't see, you know, anyone questioning or telling people to go home, or, you know, people just going about their business really.
Yeah, and some are obviously just out in the park for fun with leisure activities, not really essential activities. So yeah, the truth is that the containment or the slowdown of the virus is actually working in Seattle. We are seeing it in the data. However, it's not strictly enforced. The lockdown could be more tight than this and work better.
Yeah, and the word on parks is that they, because when they had the earlier measure in place, people had this criticism of like, oh, go to Green Lake and you'll just see, it looks like summer. It looks like there's no problem. People are out there picnicking and they're gathering in groups. And so that was, you know, a week ago. And now today, after, you know, there's more measures taking place, they've actually officially closed all the parks.
Because of the offices shutting down, all the people have been pouring into the parks and crowding them and beaches and so on. And it really will take enforcement, which the West has been unwilling to do, to make sure that people actually lock down and stop the spread of this virus. A lot of Asian countries actually are enforcing the rules, and their curves of the virus spread have been lower as a result, and their populations have been more obedient about it. While in the West, a lot of people are simply just saying, screw it, we're not gonna do anything about it, and nobody's here to stop me.
Well, that's not to say that people aren't, you know, completely listening and staying at home. I think quite a few people are, but there are still some people, not everybody is, basically. One part that did surprise me was Pike Place Market. So I was trying to think in my head, you know, where could we go to try to illustrate a place that, you know, would normally be crowded and have a lot of activity. So Pike Place Market is an obvious one. And I'd seen some photos like showing Pike Place Market just totally empty and deserted. But I went through today and a lot of those market, not a lot, but a decent amount, like more than you would think, those market stalls are still open and they're still doing business. The guys who throw the fish, that really famous area, they're still there. They're selling fish, but they're like, they fence themselves off. So you have to like do the exchange through a fence if you want to buy something. But you can still go up there and buy fish if you want. And a lot of the produce is still being sold. The flower vendors are all gone. That's really sad. But there are still some flowers there if you want to buy them. But yeah, Pike Place is interesting because I think people do use it as a grocery store and buy their produce and food there. So some parts of it are still open.
So overall, my sentiment has been that Asia has done the best job containing or slowing the virus. Really, it's not full containment, let's be clear about that. And if they ever relax their measures, it will go up again. However, in the Western world where the virus is now very prevalent, there have been just soft measures, and the West is relying on the people doing the right thing, but they're not necessarily doing it. And therefore, it has been slower and harder to make any impact against this virus. So I personally am of the opinion that we should be using stricter measures. It's already out of hand, and not enough and not soon enough has been done to do a big impact. And that's what I'm seeing. So in Washington State, after the initial measures here were first, you know, we were the first which were affected, we have started just now, finally, after weeks of this, seeing flattening of the curve of the spread. And if we relax any of that, it will go up again immediately. We, in fact, should be getting stricter